Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Divinity Original Sin. And we'll have a look at the anvil real fast, just because right here is a nice little blacksmithing area that we know of. And that's, by the way, the exit where we went before. So, Joanne is our resident blacksmither. So, we got a whetstone wheel. We have a furnace. So, let's see. We can make, a two-handed sword. Homemade two-handed sword. So we need anvil and we need a large iron bar. What does it take to make a large iron bar, I wonder?
You have that already. Actually, you know, large, right? You have regular iron bars, don't you?
Yeah. I need a large one. So, obviously can't do that. Make lots of poison resistance potions. And poison bottles. Okay. So, none of these is, I think, anything we particularly want to do. We don't have enough crafting ability for that. So, we actually can't really make anything here. We also have a furnace here, which is good for, cooking things. We can make a pizza, actually. Funnily enough.
Pizza, yeah.
Let's try to make a pizza, actually. I think we need dough, though. You wanna go get dough from someone and send it over to me?
Who would sell dough? Bread maker, maybe.
So you take a tomato, and you take a hammer, and you make tomato sauce. So you wanna get me some bread?
I don't think anyone here sells bread.
No, not bread, dough. Oh, I have weed actually. Weed and water. What do you?
Weed.
Wheat.
You saying weed?
I'm not saying weed. What is it? What do you combine wheat with to make dough? Is it just
it's
water?
Water, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Actually, I'm looking at this with the wrong person. So what we do here is we combine this thing, the chalice, with the water, and we get a cup of water. I also get a bucket of water as well while I'm at it. Actually, this person is the one that has the bucket. There you go. I'm gonna send that to Joanne. Alright, so Joanne will now go craft water with a wheat. Invalid combination. Okay, that's not how you do it. I knew there was more to this.
So you need to make the wheat into flour.
Yeah.
Try using the wheat on the grindstone.
The grindstone?
Just a guess.
The whetstone wheel? I don't think so. You want to look it up? What do I combine wheat with? I forget which one.
Sure,
it is.
I guess.
Enough. We don't you want pizza, dude?
I'm looking it up. God.
I want pizza.
I want chicken. I want liver. Fuck.
Fuck. That not a good ingredient.
Wheat plus a cup of milk makes porridge. Okay.
Oh, dude, we can make porridge. That's fucking kick ass.
Cup of milk plus potato makes a porridge with potato. Oh.
Dude, we come on.
Need a mortar and pestle.
Mortar and pestle. Oh, we had that, didn't we?
Yeah, we should have one because I picked it up.
Where is it? I swear to God, we had one before. Oh, man, don't tell me we didn't pick it up.
No, we picked it up. I'm sure we did.
Maybe we sold it though.
Why would we sell it?
I don't know. It's something I would do. Let's be honest.
Well, it's a mortar and pestle you need.
You may have to buy that from someone.
I'll ask around.
I swear we had one, but I guess I might have sold it. Why do I have a tormented? Why do I have a tormented soul?
You asked that last time. Just
I know.
Accept that it's there.
I'm giving it to you. Fuck up.
Stop giving it to me. It's probably a crafting ingredient.
All right. Well, since I don't see it here. Guess we'll continue with the Jake storyline thing, and I don't need this. Actually, let's go see where Cand is.
There's a rooster running around in the square here. You want to talk to the rooster?
I totally do.
Like, there's two roosters.
And brotherhood for all will turn the wrecked cleaver of decapitation upon you. Revolution is coming!
Dude, this fucking rooster is threatening me with the cleaver. A motherfucker. He's got nothing else to say. Is there another one around you, said?
It's one that's in the... It's on the painting chair.
Alright, so...
Painter stool.
So, let's actually have a look at Robert's ledger again, because there was two other people that had access to... Major Cecile, Captain Arhuris, Evelyn, or Esmeralda. So we've already kind of eliminated Esmeralda and Cecile, or whatever, as
well, Evelyn's right here.
Yeah, well, nobody knows that.
No, I just mean, like, she's right here.
Oh, where are you?
Like, I'm just looking at her right now. She's in this house.
Yeah, I know that. Well, I know she's here. So we know Evelyn's here-ish. There's this fucking skeleton here. Anybody? Neither of you cares to let's talk to this guy first.
But if one were to reduce the quantity of skull dust by a percentage of 2, perhaps the stability could be increased by as much as 3-fold.
Oh, a source hunter. Imagine that. Quite a bit more petite than the last of your kind I encountered, aren't you? Yes, by nearly 20 centimeters of tibia, as my memory serves. But no matter. Even if it couldn't spare its heartiest specimen, I'm sure the order sent the individual with the next highest probability of success. Huh?
Do you have any work for a trio of sailors?
Sorry, but there isn't much work for sailors in a house of medicine. Unless one of them happens to have a secret stash of healing stones.
Let's discuss your apprentice, Evelyn.
Well, she certainly possesses a critical eye and an exacting manner when it comes to making difficult medical decisions. I expect she'll be a very successful healer in her own right when the time comes. She is learning from the best, after all.
Yeah, I'll take my leave. I'll talk to her directly. Why is there sparkles? Alright, let's go talk to Evelyn right
Excuse
here.
Excuse me? This is a private sick room. Who in the name of the Seven do you think you are barging in here? Out, I say. Right this instant.
Tell me about yourself.
I'm sorry. It's this task. I'm just... Who am I to meddle with life and death this way? I'm an apprentice of the healing arts. Healing. But this decision feels like precisely the opposite. I have but one healing stone, you see, and 2 direly wounded men who need it.
Okay, we're gonna have a fucking... There's 2 guys and 1 healing stone.
Not eluding yet, though.
I've been racking my brain trying to decide on the best method to settle this grave situation, but perhaps it's better off in the hands of an esteemed source hunter. Surely you are more accustomed to weighing life and death.
Can you not follow me in here?
Alright, tell me more about the patients.
What would you like to know?
Tell me about Boris.
One of the brave few willing to traverse the trade routes plagued by the undead. A young man, but excellent in matters of business, before he fell victim to an orcish club in the north, that is. Thankfully for him, a cattle trader found him, nearly dead, but not quite so, and brought him here straight away.
How about Stephen?
Quite the venerable staple of Cycele, Stephen, and recently blessed with his 3rd grandchild. He was leading a crew of builders when a stray beam struck him in the temple, and only a few days shy of his last day of work before retirement, no less. Nearly everyone in Cycele is familiar with grinning Stephen, and, as you can imagine, he's quite dear to his family.
I'm ready to make a decision.
You are? Ah, I thank you a million times for your help. Who have you decided should receive the healing stone?
So who should get the healing stone?
It's your decision, boss.
Oh, let's see. How about Steven? Because I know full well the difficulty of growing up without a family. What the fuck? How do I know this shit? Or Boris's life has just begun. We can't cut it short now. Yeah, let's do that. Let's say Boris, actually.
Boris, it is? Yes.
Pragmatic.
You
missed the fucking
stone.
Thing.
I'm glad we'll get to save one man. My heart breaks for the other.
Boris gets to live.
Thank
no,
the Seven.
No, this is highly abnormal. What is this? This lightning?
I feel no pleasure.
We all got healed. So, that wasn't the healing stone she had.
Thank you. Thank you eternally for your help. Though... Your reaction to the healing stone, I have no idea what to make of it.
About your healing stone.
That strange reaction you caused, blue lightning from a healing stone. I've never seen anything like it. And the stone looks different now, too. Like it's devoid of life. I begin to wonder if its magical properties survived your little reaction.
You've been named as a suspect in Jake's murder case.
Is that so? Well, I handled the corpse myself, indeed. But I hardly knew the man in life. I was shocked when Ahu asked me to come to the crime scene, but Theliron had taken ill, and the responsibility fell to me. I arrived at the inn, where the body lay just where it had fallen. The injuries were like nothing I'd ever seen. A single, intricate laceration wove like lace around every inch of his skin. Neither a beginning nor an ending point were discernible. I examined the corpse and recorded what information I could. I personally delivered the corpse the short distance to the mortician's house. As far as I know, everything was, as far as a magical murder is concerned, quite normal.
Well, I take my leave. Did you find anything for her? From her?
And I'm gonna I already gave it to you.
Okay, so, Candir just got her smelly coat. And, you know, we might as well go to Mayor Cecile and we'll get his... Was it Mayor? No, it's the captain. The captain, we need to get an article from him. That's the last suspect.
Like, I've got something for you.
You have the butter and pestle?
Check your hand.
It's a ball.
Check his latest stuff.
Oh, pumpkins? Oh. Okay. Combine pumpkin with a knife. Where's the knife? There you go.
Oh, I found one.
There you go, my friend.
Thank you.
Because where's the other one I had? Oh, there it is. Okay, Johan's totally gonna get this one. Alright, Johan's now a pumpkin. Jack-o'-lantern hat. So you want to steal some clothes from the captain?
Will do. I'm just giving some stuff to Johan now.
Okay.
Got him, gave him a mortar and pestle. You can now make your stuff.
Yay! And that's rotten eggs. Alright, here we go. Combine with... flour. Let's see. There we go. Flour! Yeah, okay, that's how you do it. And then you make... Then you combine the water to make dough.
And I'm gonna make some fucking pizza. Bring me some pizza.
I will after we're gonna go to the mortician and do some other shit. We will do that this episode. We'll make pizza. Will be the fucking like just the money shot. Oh, actually, let's go talk to the Selena's here, and we had a quest to go check out the lighthouse. So let's go talk to her about that.
So good to see you again, Source Hunter.
Let's talk about the Mattis Legion.
I shall be very glad to share what information I can give you.
Expeditions and hostile to territory. So, regarding the lighthouse...
Crikey! So, there truly were undead about the lighthouse, and ghosts to boot. Did they overcome my legionnaires, I wonder? So far, not a single one has returned.
We should probably bring the legionnaires back from the lighthouse. Yep. We forgot about that. I'll do that in a minute.
Burial mounds and necromancers should be like peas in a pod, those. Could these be where the undead outbreak originated?
So we already checked out the, okay, let me just go, we checked out the burial grounds technically, I'm gonna go get those fucking soldiers to come back, I'll be back over there.
I remember literally as you meant, like you went to go talk to her, I was like, oh wait, yeah.
We didn't tell them we finished off the lighthouse, we kinda just teleported back. So we can either be nice people or it can be mean.
How did it go? Don't spare any details, we need to make a full report to the lieutenant.
We'll tell them the story, we'll be nice to them. That's an interesting story, I'll tell you all about
now
it.
Now that's an interesting story. Clean the grit from your ears and I'll tell you all about it.
Indeed. Now there's a story worthy of an audience. So let me get this straight, there's a ghost inside operating the lighthouse and you managed to do away with the bad beasties at the base of the thing. Sounds like a job well done.
And I'm sure Selenia will be thrilled to hear we did it. Another triumph for Legion Daring Do. And if this doesn't buy us a ticket home, nothing will.
Alright, so they're gonna head back. So we're gonna go back to the North Gate. And trying to remember now where she's. I think go this way.
Where is my
pepper?
Did the
small
legs
run
away?
Hello, I love traveling on you. That's what I live for.
So, they're obviously going to take the credit, but we're being nice people because they just want to go back to their families. We don't really care. Yeah, here they are.
We fought like lions. Well, look what the cat dragged in. Good to see you. My brave troops were just telling me how they proudly vanquished the undead near the lighthouse. Did you get to witness my valiant soldiers in action?
Yeah, I'm about to say again.
Yep. Quite the pair of heroes you have there.
Bravest guards we've met, like lions.
You're lying
yes,
for them.
I bet legionnaires can impress even source hunters. Now, as for my two braves here, you shall prepare to leave Sicile post haste. You're going home, as is your just reward.
Thank you, Lieutenant. All in the day's work.
We got level up and we got more reputation. Because we're nice people. Because there's no, you don't really get a reward, I think, from this. Nothing that's worthwhile, at least. And I get another skill point into something. Nasty deeds.
Nasty deeds.
Nasty. I probably want to do. I have bartering one. Considerate, righteous. So what I probably want to get is I would probably want to get one of these schools of magic, which I'll probably have a look at in a minute. Probably the one with healing or the freezing. Let's actually get that one maybe right now. Oops, what the fuck? Dude, what the fuck? These little boxes here, I can throw them everywhere.
Yeah.
Alright, let's go get the clothes from the officer's office. I think it's going to be more of a Can thing to do because he has to steal it. Hey, Can, you want to see stuff from him?
From who, sorry?
From the Captain Aris.
I already did. I already stole everything from him.
Oh, are you sure? The smelly socks? Is that it? Is that it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You already got it. I guess we'll
way ahead of you.
I guess we'll update Captain Arhu on. Just normal Arhu. On what we've been doing with this regards to this so far. I mean, actually, we don't really need to do that, because all he'll do is he'll kind of guide you in the right direction, which we don't really need. Someone leave an oven door open? So I'm going to actually head... Actually, I don't know which way I'm going, to be honest. I want to get some water schools of magic, because I wouldn't mind getting some healing and freezing abilities. So just the water magic shit, which I think this person sells. Arhu sells... Geomancy to fire.
Toe of snake! Ah, gracious patron, I see your tarred eyes looking a bit teary. I've just the potion for that. Or would you prefer a toasty fire
water
spell
of
to
life.
Dry those vapors?
We get... you and allies around you magically gain constitution? That could be good. Regeneration, heals 51 vitality, yeah, we'll take that. Freezing touch, we'll take that. Actually, maybe, Ken, maybe you should buy this shit.
Oh, yeah. Just give me a second here.
Oh, wow. Water of Life costs 9. It requires level 9. Alright, get me Freezing Touch and Regeneration, I guess. And I guess Low Current as well. Hey, let me just do that. Give me those three.
So, Water of Life.
Yeah, Regeneration. Actually, is there Freezing Touch there? Yeah, Freezing Touch, and then the other one is the buff that I saw.
Freezing Touch, Water of Life, and Regeneration.
No, not Water of Life, because that requires level 9. The buff
that's much later.
Yeah, the buff
Slow Current.
Yeah, that's the one. I just want regen and slow and the ability to slow people. We don't need rain or anything on two people.
And Freezing Touch, because you like your touch attacks.
Yes. Short range.
Ah, wait. I'm not wearing my bartering boot.
You
it's important. I've got to get all the money value.
Give me poison resistance and movement. I'll give that to Joanne. Dude, now I have the motor and pedestal. I can combine that with the bones, I think, and I'll make something. Yeah, I'll make bone dust. Well, I don't know why we need so much bone dust, but whatever. What can bone dust even be used for?
I don't know, find out.
What the hell would you possibly want to combine with bone dust?
Oh, ye of little, imagination.
I wonder if I can make a pointed stick. An arrow shaft? Dude, I made arrow shafts with the fucking branch. That's actually amazing. And now I can't do anything with this one. Alright. Did you get all the buckets? You know, I'll just go over to, I'll carry on to the
dog. I'm just seeing what I can sell.
Yeah. I think I don't have anything else for you. Treat poisoning. Yeah, I think we're pretty good.
These books aren't really worth selling.
What, the books? Yeah, I know. We should just... we should probably just dump them. I just give them to you every time. So they're worth one coin. I could make the difference. Actually, I can give you my money. I have, like, 2,000 gold.
Nah, hold on to it in case, like, you just want to do something stupid with it.
Okay. But we will finish the,
The sun is out. Yet
I don't want to talk to that guy yet. I want to talk to the dog. The dog is where the fucking party's at.
Wow, that dead sheep smells pretty great. Right. I mean,
wow. Let's see. Do you think you can smell whoever killed Jake? Yep. All right. So we have two more things. So let's see. Aris.
Did you find something for me to stick my nose? Aureus, hey. Let's give it a whiff. Definitely no Jakeness on this thing. Nope. Not a hint of Jake.
Alright, well, the last one is something that belonged to Evelyn.
Evelyn? I always thought her stink was a pretty good stink. Let me give that a sniff. This smells awesome! Too awesome! This has Jake's scent all over it.
Well, there we go. So that now that dog will obviously testify in court, and also there's a grave we totally didn't dig up here. Can't get up here. Thanks.
This one.
Yeah, one second. Let me go learn the school of magic. It's Hypodronist, right? Requires level 1. Yeah, it's hype. Okay.
Here lies Neil, killed in the line of duty. I want to go home. Here lies Judith, warrior princess.
Judith, warrior Gregory, princess.
Whose wife told him so.
One sec, one of my skills is not here. It's, what is it called? It's the Avatar of Storms. Alright. Unfortunately, our hot bar now is kind of full. But what we'll probably start doing is we'll probably start putting our buffs in the second bar here. Just to make things really easy. And like all
streamline that shit.
Alright. Actually, this is a debuff. Make it super easy for us. Okay. Let's save it. Alright. Ready to go? Dig her up.
YOLO.
Wait, where's Medora? Oh, there she is. Oh, wait, that's it. Boom pa.
Oh, epic boss. Nothing in any. Fuck, god damn it.
Okay.
Let's go kill something.
Let me go talk to this guy first.
Oh, how nice it is of you. The very picture of youth. To break the monotony of an elder's day. Wild away on this hardwood bench. Pray, let me be forward with you. Oh, sapling rose. Oh, leaf of spring. For my weary mind is troubled. And would highly prize thy gentle-handed assistance, thy kind ministrations.
About the assistance you asked of me.
You would listen to my grievances, guide me towards untroubled realms. Oh, you are truly a wonder. Oh, budding flower of the morn. Yet, that which I would tell you is of a rather private nature. So let us escape both the chill and the eye of public scrutiny. Hot spiced wine and a snug little room awaits us on the King Crab's first floor. Let us go there, so that we can warm our bones, yet make shiver our hearts with a tale of loss and sorrow.
So, he has a quest for us, but he won't give it to us here. He'll only give it to us over in the inn, but we're not going to bother with that now. What I actually want to do is we're going to go confront the mortician about the body, because he obviously did not bury the right thing, so...
So fuck that guy, let's go kill him.
Yeah, exactly. We can, actually. That's the funny thing, but...
Probably should, but...
We're actually almost done with all the quests here, so... Just want to wrap up this guy.
So, what's the bad news? More orcs rampaging through the docks? Or have those infernal statues sent another soul flying to his death?
About Jake's body.
How do you... Ah, the ledger, is it? Fool was I to leave it in the open. Or perhaps I even looked forward to being found out. Well, as you know, I have my suspects in the matter. What would you like to know?
So why does he suspect Evelyn?
I know it sounds strange suspecting the Doctor's apprentice of something so ghoulish as this, but there's few in this city could manage to transport a corpse without raising eyebrows. It was she who delivered Jake's body from the inn to the mortuary. And there was something about her that night. Some kind of excitement. Seemed she could barely contain her thoughts. That there was something thrilling about to happen. I can't quite settle it in my mind how a young medical professional would have such a strange reaction to an occasion such as that. And this may or may not have anything to do with the whole rigmarole. But her master, Dr. Theleron, bought an old shack of mine, one overtaken by undead, for an exorbitant price considering what he was getting. I never did figure what he wanted it for, but he sure seemed eager.
Ah, well, we're done with this guy. Actually, aren't we supposed to tell him off or something? Or
so,
we're supposed to tell him off?
What's the bad news?
Oh wait, about
more
the
orcs rampaging through the docks.
About the bag of gold you received for keeping quiet about Jake's body.
That gold's the only good thing to come out of this blasted affair, and I certainly plan on making some use of it.
Should we reason, charm, or intimidate him?
Are you gonna take it from him?
Yeah, dude, I totally am. Come now, you're a good man. How about Shirley Berta, whose sheep you stole, deserves the money more than anyone. Hand over the gold so you can make it way to its rightful owner, reason. Fuck, my reason's 4 and his is 3. Actually, no, I could probably win this. I'm just gonna skip it. Yeah, I won the argument.
You know, I reckon Bertia really didn't get a fair shake in all this, did she? Here, take the money and give it to her. Times are hard enough as they are.
Yeah, we just got money. I don't know how much, though. Doesn't tell me how much of money I got. I got a little bit though. Okay, we just got money. Of course, we could tell the Legion on him, and then they'll arrest him for covering up a crime. So let's go. I guess we'll go confront Evelyn. But yeah, we'll go confront Evelyn really quick about the murder thing. She is now our prime suspect.
That's like the part where you tell that guy, like, what about the poor farmer who lost the sheep?
Fuck the farmer. How about me? How about poor me? Who's lost all my time to dialogue? Need compensation cans. Alright, let's go.
That tone.
You not do that, I can't walk forward.
Can't have gotten far.
So, Evelyn. Evelyn isn't here.
Fucked off.
Oh. Would appear so. Let's talk to
this
guy.
To what do I owe the repeated pleasure, Source Hunter?
To discuss to the patients, discuss your apprentice, Evelyn.
Far be it from her to tell her master what in the Seven's name she's up to. The girl flew from here like she just heard the location of the Philosopher's Stone. She even left her pouch unattended in the next room. Most unlike her, to be sure.
Alright, what about her pouch?
She usually keeps it within sight at all times. Very strange she'd leave it behind. It's in the next room if you'd like to take a look.
Where do you think she would have run off to?
I'd try her house, for starters. It's not far from here. I'll mark the location on your map.
Yeah, what the discussions of the... discuss the patients you were attending to.
The world belongs to the young, they say, and Boris will live to take his peace. Thank you for your help in this matter.
All right. Oh, we know about the minor healing potions now. So her backpack's right here. For some reason, it's going to be stealing it if I take it. But that's okay. Oh, we have a key to Evelyn's house now. But that's all the time we got for today, guys. Take care.
Man!
We're almost done this stuff.
watching me.